सर वेलकम। हेलो सर वेलकम।
हाय हाय सर।
यस सर। शैल वी स्टार्ट और शैल वी वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स? वी हैव ओनली थ्री
सर
पर्सन्स आर
वी
देयर।
विल वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स, लेट देम कम बिकॉज मोस्ट प्रोबली दे विल बी
ओके
जॉइनिंग, विल ट्राइंग टू जॉइन।
ओके थैंक यू।
Sir, it is one answer.
Thanks for your curiosity, but you meant you spell one amps. It's one ohm.
Sorry, it's one.
Because it's correct. Your calculation is correct because this type of curiosity we did a mistake in our exam.
Ah yes, exact. Yes, we think that we know, but while putting it, we forget.
Yes, because in our exam we can be able to see that units like this. Because that the intention is, because if we see the question papers, so out of 27 question papers, we may first we see the 5 to 10 questions. All the questions are we may remember that these questions we discuss in the classroom. So that's why we, due to the curiosity, we do the things.
So the same thing happened actually.
Asitambi and Suresh will not be joining. So if anybody else. We can join. We can continue.
Okay. We will start that. And we have one more question. Sorry, like this. The same question, same number they asked in that exam. What is the answer for this question?
Three ohms, sir.
You mean say with the all the
3 ohms.
3 ohms. But once again, due to the curiosity, these two are series, and we think this one ohm is connected in parallel. So that's why, due to the curiosity, we did mistake.
Sir, if suppose...
Yes. Suppose if you have a R, A, B, what is the answer?
Then it will be parallel, right?
If you have a A, B like this, if they ask the question... Because if you ask the question, the answer is entirely different. We didn't say it's a 2 ohm, or we didn't say 1 ohm, because there is a battery is there, so we are not able to predict the answer. So later I saw the question, how to solve this question, but this question is not asked in the exam, and we have this questions. I hope you saw the
question. I have a doubt in super question theorem, sir.
Yes, sir, tell me, sir.
Sir, actually, in the superposition theorem, said you will be calculating the IL1, right? So, if there are 3 120 ohms resistance will be there, you will be calculating, like it is connected on a, like a star connection. So, in that you will be calculating the IL1 for the middle 120 ohms. So, that you used this current divider rule. And calculated the, like, multiplied by the opposite resistance, yes. Current individual total current divided by sum of the resistance into the individual resistance, yes. Opposite resistance. Sorry. So in the sum of the resistance part, I have doubts. So the sum of the resistance is the total equivalent resistance of the circuit, right?
No, that's why. For example, say this is 10 amps. Okay.
Okay.
This is 120 ohm. here 120 ohm. Here 120 ohm. So just one second.
That we had a 12 volt power supply and 3 120 ohms connected there.
Yes, yes.
So we got the first we found out the current, total current.
So for assume that we have a circuit. Okay. Okay, the current flow through this R1 we consider as I1. Current flow through R2 is I2. Current flow to I3 is R3. Okay, we didn't know any resistance value. Now, what is the current flow through R1?
10 amps.
10 amps. Okay. Now, what is the current away from this resistance R1?
10 amps.
10 amps. Now, this 10 amps is divided into two parts. That is two parts, I2 and I3. Correct?
Yeah, correct.
Due to the Kirchhoff's current law. Now, see, it is 120 ohm. This is 120 ohm. Now, our objective is to find current flow through R2. So now here you consider this part. We forgot about this one. This part. So now R2 and R3 are connected in parallel combinations. What is the current division rule?
Total current.
The current entering the node is equivalent to the current outgoing to the node.
Total current.
As we didn't consider this R1 because the current is same. So we consider the circuit after this resistance. So total current, which is equal to current flow through resistance R2, which is equal to I2, which total current into opposite branch resistance. Opposite, what is the opposite branch for R2 is R3, R3 divided by total resistance. Means we didn't say this, all this, we take these branches only. So we considered R2 and R3. So that's why we say instead of total resistance, we say sum of the branch resistance.
Okay.
If you use the word sum of the branch resistance, means we consider only R2 and R3 alone.
So consider if there is a one more resistance R4 in parallel to R2 and R3.
So we have one more resistance here.
Yeah.
That is okay, for understanding, we draw like this. Here, 10 amps, R1, R2, R3, R4. Here resistance is 120. So and assume that all the resistance have the same value. Now our objective is to find this current I2. So this is your question, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now I2, which is equal to total current into opposite branch divided by sum of the branch resistance. which is equal to total current 10 into sum of the branch resistance. How many branches are there? We have three branches. Out of three branches, we have three resistance, 120, 120, 120. Into opposite branch. Opposite for the R2, which is our opposite branch, these two are opposite, correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
So that's why here, instead of using 120, we say R2 parallel R4. So that's why the answer is 10 into 120, 120 means 60, half of 60. The value, divided by 120 plus 120 plus 120. Okay. So we have, so that's why in general, if you have a three resistance means, before going to the current division rule, one twenty, 10 amps. This is I2. So opposite branch. This is the opposite branch. First, we convert these two resistance into single resistance. Then we can be able to apply the current division rule. So here we didn't have a confusions because, so that's why we say current division rule is applicable for only two resistance. In the college, we can be able to use this formula, but now we can be able to say that like this. We convert these two resistance like this, then we apply the division rule.
Sir, but in that case, why it will be like 120, 120, 120 in the denominator? It should be 120 plus 60, right?
Yes. In this case.
Yeah, what you told is the I2 yes. value.
To yes, yes, sorry. I2. In the previous, I did a mistake. In the previous also, we didn't say. That's why, in general, if we have a more than two resistance, we convert the opposite branch into single resistance. Sorry, thanks for your information. Usually convert that. Then we apply the current division rule. So that's why we can get correct answers.
Yeah.
Due to the curiosity, we did a mistake.
We will like 10 amps into 60 by 120 plus 60, right?
10 into 60
divided by 120 plus 60.
Yes, 120 plus 60. The same time, we have a question like this. Here 120, 120. 120. Now, IL, which is equal to the I2, which is equal to 10 into
240.
Opposite branch. In the opposite, they have a two resistance are connected in series. So that's why we put 240. Okay. But mostly the series resistance, series parallel combinations solve the problems. The numeric, the resistance value, we can easy to calculate the resistance like this. Instead, for example, if they ask the questions, they did in 120, they give 120, 120, they give 60, 60. By this way, they give the question, but that, then only we can be able to get the answer immediately and we can be able to apply the logic also. 60, 60, we can 120, 120, 120, we have a half of the value. So directly we can be able to say pi amp.
Yeah.
So these type of problems, they will ask instead of 120, 120.
Sir, in the voltage division rule, same like this now, as you told I have doubt in that also. If two resistances are parallel and one more in series with it.
So this is the question you ask?
Yeah, correct.
So now, if we have two resistance, we use the formula. V2 which is equal to V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is the formula,
yes.
Okay?
Yes.
Here, this R2 and R3 are connected in parallel combinations. If you have a parallel combinations, the voltage is common for both R2 and R3. Say they ask the resistance value, voltage across R3 means default, the question is the voltage across R2 also the same. So for this, first we convert these two resistance into single resistance. So that is
V3.
Which is equal to 10 into same 10. Resistance. That is this.
Yes.
We didn't use the R3. We used the 10 into 10 divided by 10 plus 10. Divided by 10 plus the same thing. So that's why if you write these equations, it may be complicated to you. So that's why here we think that the parallel combination, the voltage is same. So that's why we convert the resistance like this, the circuit like this, which is equivalent to like this. This is R1, R2, R3. Here 10, here 5. Assume that the connected voltage is 15. Earlier I told 10 for easy to solve the problem, 15. So now here the value is 5. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So 15. So that means here the answer is 5. So in the parallel voltage is same. So the voltage across R3 is 5 voltage. So in general, they didn't ask the n number of resistance, they didn't ask that. So you convert the resistance, convert into two resistance for both parallel and series. And
forward, sir.
Okay. So this type of question asked in the exam. So once again, here first I put a 10, then I write the 100. So that's why here
40. 40.
So these type of questions we have, they ask in the exams. Okay, sir. There is any other questions?
There is one more question also there.
Yes, tell me, sir.
In the single phase transformer, you solved one question, but I don't know how to derive it. You said the answer directly.
7.2 10 volt.
100 by 7.2 kV impedance 10%. If yes. We measure the HV terminals, you said we have to multiply 100 to 10. Yeah. How to derive it, sir? What is the formula actually for that? Any idea?
Yes, sir. So here transformer. So we say this end is primary. This end is secondary. How to identify the primary and secondary winding? If we give a supply, if we give a supply to the winding, that winding we call as a primary. Output. Where we get the output, that we call as a secondary.
Secondary, yeah.
So here we give the input. So that's why it is a primary. Here we get the output, so we call as a secondary. Okay. Sorry. So depends upon the applied voltage, we can be able to identify primary, secondary. In other words, suppose we have a transformer like this. /230 voltage. Here we say this side we call as a high voltage winding. In this side we call as a low voltage winding. Okay. From these details, we didn't say this one is a primary winding, this one is secondary winding, because from this data we can be able to say which one is the high voltage side, which one is a low voltage side. Here we didn't say which one is a primary, which one is secondary. So in general, we practically in the left side we call as a primary winding, in the right side we have a secondary winding. So now the question is, this is primary, secondary, here high voltage winding, low voltage winding. So now see this transformer. This transformer, 11 kV is a primary side, 0.4, that is 400 voltage, is a secondary side. So this is the high voltage side, this is the low voltage side. Okay?
Okay.
Now, in the transformer, we have two losses are there. One loss is a core loss, another one is a copper loss. Core loss, copper loss, or iron loss, copper loss. To find the iron loss, we go for how to find the iron losses? To conduct no load test. To find copper loss, we conduct
short circuit test.
Short circuit test.
in general, so first, this is the transformer. We have a transformer. So if we need, if we find the no load loss, what we will do, the secondary becomes open circuit, correct? The secondary becomes open circuit. So yeah. Here,
yes,
we give input supply to the primary and the secondary becomes open. Here we connect the wattmeter. Here we connect the wattmeter, and this is the open. So now in this wattmeter, reads some value. That value we call as a PI. To conduct a no load test, how much voltage will we apply? We will apply rated voltage. So here we apply the 11 kV. So we can get it at that. Similarly, for short circuit test, we apply the to find copper losses, we go for short circuit test. To conduct a short circuit test, we apply the rated current. So we need to measure the rated current. So in the earlier circuit, we need to connect the voltmeter. Here we need to connect the ammeter. So here we put the ammeter. Say this transformer is 1600 kVA 11 kV / 400 volt transformer. This transformer rating is 1600 kVA, 11 kV / 400 volt. So from this, we calculate the current. How to calculate the current? Power is equal to VI cos theta. For understanding purpose, assume that if it is a single phase transformer, means 1600, we can be able to use the formula, actually root 3, but it's a lengthy one for under. So that's why I use the single phase transformer, which is equal to 400 into, sorry, we consider self. Ip into cos theta, considered usually in our college during the lab test, because it is a short circuit test. In the short circuit test, we didn't connect any load, so assume that it is a unity. In general, assume that it is a unity power factor. So we derived some value. It's approximately Okay, sorry. So to find the copper losses, we apply the rated current. Assume that if we calculate the rated current is approximately 40 amps, assume that. Now from Ohm's law, that we can have, because this, if we connect it like this means the 11 kV, we can be able to use that. So in general, usually during the short circuit test, so this is open circuit. This is circuit diagram for open circuit test. This is the circuit diagram for short circuit test. So this test is used to conduct iron loss, which is used to find copper loss. Here we apply the rated voltage. How to find the rated voltage? Because if it is a here power source, to monitor in the voltage, here we connect the voltmeter. So by adjusting the auto transformer, we can be able to get the rated current, the rated voltage. If the rated voltage at that time, how much power is